inaugural words, Center for Wellness Management and Counseling, which is headed by our very competent counselor, Mrs. Archana, ensures that we give timely inputs to our students and to so many others who are in need of her services. We all know we are going through difficult times. And during this pandemic, there is a possibility that we lose our balance that we require between the virtual and the real world. So we find that we might undergo stress. We may require some inputs. So what better person than Dr. Aditya Barve, who is also a very competent advisor, other than being a doctor, a medical practitioner. And he will take us through a very important dimension of the precautions one must take. We would look at it more from the scientific aspect. And as far as the psychological aspects are concerned, and that is coping through the stressful times that we are going through, we have, of course, our own in-house counselor, Archana Kotarkar. Without much ado, I warmly welcome Dr. Aditya Barve. Sir, it is a great pleasure to welcome you, though virtually, into our college. Hopefully, when we come out of this virtual compulsion, we will be able to physically welcome you into the portals of our college. And with those few words, I warmly welcome you. I welcome the participants. I welcome the counselor herself. And I hope that these deliberations will give us a lot of inputs and help us to cope with the times we are going through. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. So to put light on immunity and social etiquettes during pandemics, we are privileged to have amongst us Dr. Aditya Barve. He is an Ayurvedic physician and director of Health Services Goa. He has done Bachelor of Ayurvedic Medicine and Surgery in Goa University itself, Diploma in Panchakarma, Pune, Postgraduate Diploma in Hospital and Healthcare Management, Symbiosis, Pune. He has presented a scientific paper on Ayurveda at 9th International Congress on Traditional Asian Medicine at Kiel, Germany in 2017. He has presented scientific paper at International Conference on Physical Education and Sports Science held in Goa. Presented paper at National Seminar on Medical Plants held in Goa in 2016. Scientific paper on pain management selected at first Ayush conference held at Melbourne, Australia in 2018. Appointed as member of Yoga Cell formed by Goa Education Development Corporation to monitor and implement yoga in school education. Played leading role in concept and implementation of Goa's first institutional herbal garden at Primary Health Center, Aldana, Goa, in association with Goa Biodiversity Board. He is the author of two books on Ayurveda, Member Secretary Rog Kalyan Samiti, PHC, Aldana, and Joint Secretary at Arogya Bharti, Goa. Now, I request Dr. Aditya to kindly take over with today's session. Doctor, I think you are muted.
Okay, yes. Thank you, Archana. I think everyone can hear me now.
You are audible.
Yes, okay. And thank you, sir. So just a small question to begin with. All these students, they are like law students?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, so I have to be very careful with my words, no? Okay, yeah, because I don't know who might sue me for a wrong terminology or for no. Just kidding, just to start with. Because what I've observed is whenever the topic of health, you know, it comes, everybody has becomes, you know, they become very serious. You have to be. But while this lecture is going on, I want everybody attention and just to focus what can they do to you know, keep well, to maintain their health, because a lot has been heard since last almost 6 to 7 months that I think corona, COVID-19, all the tests, those are done. So all these things are constantly hitting our brains, you know, constantly disturbing us. And the common man has become, because of the internet, they've become like gurus of everything. They know which test to be done. But in fact, when they come to primary health center, they advise the doctor to do a specific test. So it's really strange sometimes. The doctor who has learned so much, but the patient himself is telling what he wants. This was not the case so few years back. So the topic was given to me is the immunity and the social etiquette during this COVID-19. Yes. So before we go into, you know, this immunity and everything, I'll just brief this out. That whenever we hear the immunity concept, okay, it is the immunity and everything what we know about is the, what we know has been the contribution of the modern science. Okay, that's the allopathy science what they have given us. So the immunity what we know is by the active immunity, the passive immunity. I will not go into the details, but immunity to a disease is gained by a particular type of a vaccine, right? Since childhood, we have been given n number of the vaccines. It may be polio, it may be BCG, penta, and all these things are there. Everybody has taken it. But what is the Ayurveda's point of view? And is it really important? That I'm just going to focus about. To begin with, just I will tell everybody or ask everybody, when was the first antibiotic found? The first antibiotic was roughly found around 100 to 150 years back max. The first vaccine was found around 100 years back only. So before the allopathy system came into existence or they started, you know, progressing, what was the scenario? Since antibiotic did not get, did not existed, all the people who got infection, they used to die. Everybody used to, who got malaria, did they die? Everybody who got a lung infection, did they die? No. Definitely not, because the human race, it has survived since last so many thousands and thousands of years, and they have only survived because of the some medicine which they came to know from the nature around us. So the nature around us has given everything to us, our needs of food as well as the medicines to us. And from this only the science of Ayurveda came into existence. The sages, they thought that they saw all the humanity suffering. So they sat, they meditated, and they found a solution to this via the Ayurveda. So what does the Ayurveda definitely mean? I'm not going to definition and everything. For us, Ayurveda basically means jadi buti. You go to a few 50 years back, people used to go to some practitioner, and he used to give some jadi buti. He used to tell, he used to give root, leaf of some this, or maybe some kada he used to give. Take this and you'll be fine. That is what the Ayurveda was restricted to. But this is this the real picture of Ayurveda? No, definitely not. So what does Ayurveda mean? So Ayurveda means the Ayurveda runs with the two aims. One, maintenance health of the healthy and curing of the disease. So that's why the maintenance health of the health of the healthy person is very much required what we are facing today. Okay. The after this pandemic was hit, you know, initially because of the lockdown, it was very smooth. But suddenly now, after the lockdown has been removed, the cases are being spiked. The good thing what we are noticing is the recovery rate is nearly around 80%. What the current statistics are going, it is the 80%, and the death rate is as low as 1.64%, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, so these figures are basically really good. And this is due to the intervention of thousands and thousands of health workers, the doctors. I'm not restricting it to any pathy, all the pathies, homeopathic doctors, Ayurvedic doctors, the allopathy doctors, all are working really hard to keep the entire Savaso Karod Deshvasio population of our nation to, fight this pandemic. So basically, now if we come to know that if Ayurveda doesn't have any vaccine, okay, how do we approach to a disease which is totally new? Because according to allopathy, this is a totally new disease, right? So does a science which is in 1500 years old have any solutions to this kind of situation? Answer is yes, definitely we have. Because no doubt how a disease, however new a disease is, it is new as per the allopathic guidelines. It is a bacterial, it is a viral, or it is a fungal. It is a classification according to them. But to according to Ayurveda, what the diagnosis is, that we find out, Ayurvedic physician finds out, and then he treats accordingly. So that's why the medicine or the treatment varies from patient to patient, or it differs from season to season. So I will be giving medicines to fight this pandemic as an immunity booster. What is good in rainfall might not be good in the summer season, or might not be so effective in the winter season. So according to this, if we change and if we keep our lifestyle properly, our food habits correctly, that plays a very, very key and a major role in fighting the disorders. How? Shocked? Yes, it is true. And this is what we have forgotten, because as we stay in India, we have to follow the lifestyle advised to us by our elderly. But what we are doing, we are educated, but we are not educated health-wise. We do not know the reason. That's why we say, what my grandfather used to tell is has no significance now. I will get up whenever I want. I will eat whenever I want. I will sleep whenever I want. I will eat whatever I want, or what has been shown to me in the advertisement, or whatever comes on the Swiggy with a discounted price, I will have that. So this is the psychology for us being healthy. So this is not the case. Okay. So how to remain healthy? All these questions definitely will come to our mind. So what should I do to keep myself healthy? Let's go down there. What should I do so I also protect myself and I protect my family as well as the others? This is what we are going to briefly focus upon. So Ayurveda says something called as Dinacharya. Dinacharya means what? Our entire day's routine, right from getting up to going to bed. If this is done in a proper way, in a proper time, in a proper chronology, this definitely helps us in maintaining good health. Let's start with getting up early in the morning. Okay. We all, you know, like to get up late in the morning, that is after the sunrise. Ayurveda advises to get up before the sunrise. Actually, classically, if you go to see, they have advised the time to get up is literally 1 to 1.5 hours before the sunrise. Literally impossible for every one of us to die down if somebody is waking up as early as, for, you know, 4:30 or 5 o'clock in the morning. Okay, some people might be just to check their WhatsApp messages or something like that, but not everybody. Okay, so it is not practical today because, you know, working hours are late and there are a number of reasons. But how close can we come to this? Okay, the usually sunrise timing in India, I think, is 6 to 6:15 or 6:20 max. So can we get up at as early as 6 o'clock in the morning? Can we do that? Yes. Now you will say, what difference does it make if I get up at 6 o'clock, I get up at 7 o'clock, or I get up at 8 o'clock? Simple, I tell you. See, according to Ayurveda, a whole body is composed of three main factors. They are called as Vata, Pitta and Kapha. You must have heard this term. Maka Vata ilo, they say some people. Maka Pinta zale, maka Kapha zalo. These are very common terms used by the people. So all these entities are present in our body, and imbalance in these three is the root cause of any disorder in our body. It might be cough, cold, fever, any infection, or it might be cancer also. So all these things, if they are balanced, Vata, Pitta and the Kapha, it gives us health. Okay, so you must be wondering, what do you mean by Vata? What is the governing force to do any action in the body? See, currently I'm speaking, my vocal cords, okay, the sound which is coming out, my fingers are moving, my eyes are blinking. All these actions, one force is driving it, and that force or the energy, it is called as the Vata energy. What is the Pitta? The heat, the necessary heat for any conversion in the body. The food that I'm eating is digested with the heat of the Pitta, and it is converted into the body absorbable form. That is called as the Pitta. What is Kapha? Kapha means what, the building block of our body. Okay, because whatever we are eating has to get digested and it has to be assimilated. So food, when digested, it is get converted. So for anything new generation, the new cells or anything, or giving a shape to the body, the Kapha is very much required. Okay, so all these things have I mean, if they are in equilibrium, our health is maintained. Why am I telling you all these things? Now listen. According to Ayurveda, the right time when we get up before the sunrise, the vata in our body, it helps because the climatic conditions before the sunrise helps us to activate the vata in the body. Vata is nothing but the energy, as I told you. So when we get up early in the morning, we are a bit energized. Our energy levels are a little high. And this vata gives us the sensation to remove the unwanted, waste out of the body. So the sensation to pass the feces is generated before the sunrise. So many patients who are suffering from constipation or do not, have trouble with digestion, everything, if they get up early in the morning before sunrise, it really helps them a lot. Okay. So secondly, when we get up after the sunrise, you will see that we are not that our energy level is not that very high. You know, we are typically go on, sushega athava jela ani masa niduya. This kind of mentality is because we are getting up late, that is after the sunset, and after the sunset it is said that the kapha is, which is, sticky, slimy in nature, takes over the body, and that's why it also pushes us down, it makes us more sluggish. So the key point here is, you will say, now everything what you have told is correct, but how it is related to the current pandemic? Yes. So anything excess in the kapha in the body will give rise to your cough, your cold, your thyroid, your any lung disorders, your asthma, everything. So what should we do? The first thing, if we want our kapha to be, balanced in the body, the first thing we have to start with getting up early in the morning. You will see that the person who gets up early in the morning is very much active. Just imagine when you get up early in the morning, and supposingly you hear any song, the whole day the song will be running through your mind, because our mind is fresh. Whatever we listen or whatever we read is immediately recollected and stored by our mind. It doesn't happen so when we get up a little bit late, we are lazy and we want something to boost our energy, and that what is, it is supplied by the tea or the coffee, the tannin or the caffeine what we take. So if we do not want any cold, cough, asthma, thyroid, obesity, anything, we have to get up early in the morning and not after the sunrise. Small but plays a very key important role. Trust me, I've tried these remedies on many people who have been continuously taking some laxatives, who have continuous digestion problems, and just by changing this habit, they have done well in their life. The thyroid levels have a little bit come down, the stress level have been come down, they do not feel lazy anymore. So all these things matter a lot. Second one, after getting up early in the morning, what do we do is, as advised by the TV, we take a glass of hot water, we add a little bit of lemon, we add a little bit of honey, mix together and drink. Isn't it? Wrong. Is Ayurveda advising this? No. So who is advising this? This is advertised by the famous actors, the actresses, and some models, and whoever comes on the television. Is there any scientific reason to this? No, definitely not. Why? Because Ayurveda is advising to take sip of hot water. Here the quantity matters. Okay. How much quantity remains in your one, this fist? Okay. Is, you can drink the hot water one or twice, not more than that. Okay. Is sufficient for you. But if you take more than that water, it is not good, especially to the Goan climate. Okay. Because here the rainfall is from June till September or October. Okay. So the water requirement is not very large. We stay in a wetland. As we go towards the North Indian side, the water requirement is more because of the dryness in the climate. There you have to drink lots of water. But in Goa, you have to drink water as per your thirst, and you have to drink lukewarm water only, except in the summers and in the October month when the temperature is little bit on the higher side. That time you can drink room temperature water. Okay. So getting up early in the morning and drinking 1 liter, 2 liter, half liter of water with lemon, honey, if you are doing it, please stop. Okay. I have not even found one person in my entire 11 years of practice who has become slim and who is fit just by drinking warm water with lemon and honey. It doesn't happen so. In spite of Ayurveda advices, honey is never to be mixed with any hot or heaty food substances. So in hot water also, it is never advised. Okay, lemon, again, it being sour in taste, it increases the kapha, the phlegm inside your body. So in this pandemic, when everybody is getting cough, cold, and the it is going towards your lung to create that pneumonia thing, it is definitely not advised. Okay, so if you want to drink, take plain lukewarm water, not more than, you know, quarter cup of water, which is small cup, not more than that will be good for you all. Okay, so the second one thing is the exercise. Exercise again plays a very key role, because today, because of the pandemic, we have stopped going outside, we have stopped traveling, and the whole day we are just sitting on a chair or relaxing on the sofa. A movement is also restricted. So what if, and what about the food habits? The food habits are as they were, or perhaps a food habits are increasing day by day. Everybody is making, you know, cakes in pressure cookers, and they are making different, trying all the different recipes. Everybody is trying dalgona coffee and everything, all they have tried. Okay, so the food, they are whatever we like, we are increasing, but are we burning those calories? We are not burning the calories. So you will say, you know, the doctor, the gyms are closed, I used to go to gym, I used to work out. But is there any remedy given by the Ayurveda to, you know, in shortcut, within no span of time, burn our calories and give exercise to the whole body? Yes, the answer is Surya Namaskar or the sun salutations. Okay. That's why 148 countries have been given and put forward the concept of the International Yoga Day, and 21st June was declared as 21st June. You all should be very lucky, because Archana is a very good yoga practitioner. So she can easily demonstrate all the simple and as well as the complex yogasanas for all of you all, out of which you all can just start practicing Surya Namaskaras a day. So yes, but how to do it? Okay. Just because the Dr. Aditya has come and told tomorrow, don't start with, you know, 10, 20, 30 Surya Namaskaras. Okay, tomorrow you will start with only one. Okay, Surya Namaskar is nothing but it is a cycle wherein 10 asanas are practiced. So first day you have to do only one. Second day you can increase another one to it. Okay, and as you can continue doing it, maybe 10, 12, 30, 40 is also fine. It takes roughly 10 to 15 minutes of this Surya Namaskaras, okay, to keep you all fit. Okay, so the right time to do is it early in the morning after, you know, brushing your teeth and everything, but they have to be done on empty stomach. Okay, you cannot do any yogasanas after, you know, taking some solid food. It is not advised. Okay, so after this, what you all can do is just five to 10 minutes you can do the breathing exercises. Why breathing exercises? Because as I told you, we are not moving, we are not running, we are not exercising. So what happens is our lungs, you know, are using, taking very less amount of oxygen inside. Just for instance, this is called a shallow breathing. Okay. So the shallow breathing, what we do, if this is the size of the of our lung, we are just utilizing about this much. When we are shallow breathing, just if this is the cycle, this is how we breathe, we are just utilizing the 10 to 20% of our lung, not to our fullest capacity. So what we have to do is we have to take a deep breath, hold for 4 to 5 seconds, and then slowly exhale. You will start to notice that when you exhale after holding your breath, when you expire out, the time taken is little bit much more, because as I told you, if this is the oxygen that we are breathing in, what about this? This area doesn't get utilized. So the remaining carbon dioxide here gets pumped out, the fresh oxygen is pulled in, and because a body is, you know, well oxygenated, each and every cell tissue of our body gets oxygen properly. When it gets the oxygen properly, all the nutrients of the food that we are eating reaches to the tiniest cell and the tissue and the every smallest part, and unwanted wastes are also thrown out. This is the small concept, but it helps in the long run, because today the people are there, I mean young children, they are complaining of cholesterol, okay, they are complaining of thyroid, weight gain, they are complaining of high uric acid. This is all because of our sedentary lifestyle. Surya Namaskaras and 10 to 20, 10 minutes approximately of breathing exercises will really help you out in, you know, prevention of all these disorders. And you know, keeping your immunity in place. This is how the our Ayurveda moves about in prevention of immunity. Okay, then the next point which I would like to focus is giving a massage to the body. Again, When we were small, I mean, I think everybody, almost 100% of whoever is attending this must have got a nice massage. But if the massage is stopped, once a child, you know, reaches, you know, 3 or maybe 6 months at the max, not more than that. But do the adults take a massage? No, definitely not. We used to only do it during the Diwali time, when, you know, our mother or grandmother in the house used to force us, sit, you know, you have to apply the oil and you have to have a nice bath with something called as utne, that is a fragrance herbal powder. But that is also restricted to one day. Why not do it, you know, every day? It is not possible. I know that, because everybody is busy working, etc. But at least once in a week, it is really possible. So how do we do it? We have to take sesame oil, tirache tel, which is called as. If you don't find sesame oil, you have to take lukewarm or fresh coconut oil, which is easily available for us, and just apply to your body. Start from your head, neck, back, you know, both the hands, legs, just apply. Keep for 5 to 10 minutes max, and then have bath with, you know, hot water. The massage really helps, you know, for increasing the microcirculation, keeping our skin fit. Because, you know, massage is just not for soothing and, you know, relaxation of our mind. It is also good for the skin. And trust me, the skin is also the entry as well as the exit point of the body. Okay, because the skin has sweat glands. Whatever the unwanted waste is there is thrown out in the form of sweat. And the sunlight or any light that enters inside our body, it penetrates through the skin. And then the cholesterol is converted into vitamin D. Today, a lot of youngsters in their 30s are also facing problems of lack of vitamin D. And for that, what they do? They will just take the supplement. They will take calcium. They will take vitamin D from the external sources. But if we massage every day and just expose to ourselves to the sunlight in the morning, maybe 10 to 15 minutes also, the vitamin D problem, the joint pain, such arthritis, this problem will not be there. Again, the only contraindication here for the doing of massage is when you are having indigestion, you're not supposed to do massage. I mean, you are having problems like constipation, you are having loose motions, you are having vomiting, you're feeling feverish. And if you're having severe body ache, you're not supposed to do the massage. You know, just let it go. And when you have, because all these things, whatever I'm telling you, is for the healthy person to remain healthy. But you are, if you are having some difficulties, if you are having some digestive related issue, it is better to consult an Ayurvedic doctor before doing massage. Because trust me, nobody will tell you this. Because according to everyone, Ayurveda doesn't have any side effect. No matter what we do, how many herbs we take, in what quantity we take, it is definitely not going to harm us. Please remove this misconcept from your mind. Because after all, it is a medicine. And any medicine, if taken at the wrong time, in the wrong quantity, you know, by a wrong person, can definitely harm us. The harm may not be, you know, to the very severe extent, but yes, to some extent, it is not advised. Okay. So the points what we have discussed is, the first, getting up early in the morning, doing Surya Namaskaras, you know, then doing breathing exercises of 5 to 10 minutes. And after that, doing oil massage for 5 to 10 minutes, taking bath with hot water. And after that, the next part, which is important for us and as well as for the immunity, is our food habits. Okay, it is said that, you know, dane dane pe likha hai khane wale ka naam. So it is, and we should, you know, eat to live and not live to eat. Okay, so in current lockdown, I think everybody is doing that thing only. We are also trying to live, but we are also trying to eat. Everybody is at home. Everybody has access to YouTube and all the good recipes, everybody is, you know, trying out at home. No harm. Everybody likes to, you know, to try different food items. But the only thing is, focus on what we used to do and what is good for us. Because the overall trend, what I'm seeing is, whatever was advised by a previous generation was given a lot of thought about, and it was advised that, trust me, that diet was very well scientifically planned, because they're short of time. Otherwise, only on these food habits and science behind it, I can give lecture in 1.5 hours easily. 90 minutes it takes. What was the science behind food? So whatever ancestors have given, it also holds a very importance. How to move about your diet? Ayurveda says, whatever is grown in your region, in your vicinity, in your state, is definitely good for you all. whatever grows in that season, you have to consume it. For example, I'll give you for a small example. In this rainy season, in outside, if you go to see, is a vegetable which is locally available. It is called as taikira. Okay, why does it come in the rainy season? Because the taikira is said to be the best digestive and the antifungal property it has. And you will see in the rainy season, because of the high humidity, many people are suffering with the fungal infections. So taikira, if we consume in the rainy season, the fungal infections that we see will definitely go down. This has been researched, proved, and everything what I'm telling you. So consume whatever is available in that season. Okay. So whatever grows here is, first thing is coconut. So which oil is the best for us? Ideally, it is the coconut oil, but we are running behind olives. Are olives grown here? No, definitely not. Okay, olives are grown in the Western country where the climate and the seasons are totally different. No harm trying it for some, you know, sometimes, or as a dressing over your salads and everything. It is even permissible, but it is fine. But as a main course, you have to use the coconut oil, which is the best. And the latest research, it is again showing that the coconut oil doesn't increase the harmful cholesterol, but it helps in bringing up the useful cholesterol in the body. There's something called as useful cholesterol also. Okay, because whenever I say, you know, cholesterol, many people, you know, start getting feared, because many people, you know, they come with a report and they come to the clinic and they start, doctor, I've started getting chest pain. I'm getting chest pain since, you know, yesterday evening. So I asked them, what happened? No, I just did a blood test in the morning and I found my cholesterol to be high. Okay. I took my report, the cholesterol was little high and that's why I got scared, and now I'm fearing that I might have heart attack. So just because the level in the report is a little bit of high, we suddenly get scared that we might get a heart attack. So I cross-check, and again it has been proved scientifically that only cholesterol might not be the reason for the, you know, all the heart diseases that we see. So, and it's been proven that the ghee, that desi ghee what we use, prepared in a proper scientific way, whatever our grandmother and all used to do, by churning the buttermilk, removing the cream and heating it. This is the way, if we extract the ghee, it doesn't increase the cholesterol. It has been scientifically proved today. Similarly, the coconut oil also, the locally grown what is there, it doesn't, you know, if we take in a permissible amount, it doesn't increase the cholesterol and it is good for us. So whatever is grown in the region, we have to use it. So again, it comes that a staple food is what? Rice and fish, right? I think Goans cannot stay without all these, both the things. But sudden shift today, what I see is people have started saying that, no, I've stopped eating rice because I think it is going to increase my sugar level. Because I'm a diabetic, I should stop eating rice. And I've switched over to wheat. Is it good? It is definitely not good. Because again, where the wheat is grown in the northwest region, that is Punjab and etc. This, where the, it is little bit on the cooler side. Okay. And as we go towards South India, where the rainfall is a little bit of high, the rice is said to be our staple food. It is easily grown here, so we should rely more on rice. But only thing about rice is not to be consumed whenever it is a new crop. Newly harvested rice, it is definitely heavy to digest. Okay, and it is it has shown a little bit trend towards increasing cholesterol or diabetic, high glycemic index, etc. But just because of this reason, we cannot switch towards the wheat. Rice is our staple food. So what do? We have to use rice, which is minimum 6 to 1 year old. You get this rice, old rice in the market. But if you bring rice at home and if you don't know whether it is new or old, what should we do it? We should, you know, pan fry the rice before cooking it. Ask your mother to do this. The simple rice what we bring, you just have to fry it in a vessel and then make rice out of it. It is definitely not going to harm us. So these are the simple tricks, not only for, you know, our common cough cold, but also for our weight gain, you know, for our thyroid, for our diabetes. These all the tricks what I'm telling are really helpful. So again, what is the best time to eat? If Is there a concept of correct time of eating? You know, people have forgotten this, because earlier when people used to eat before going to work and after coming home. But today, what is the concept? इट इज व्हेन वी मीट somebody, व्हाट वी डू, चल यार चा मारपाक या. ओके, बिकॉज वी मीट somebody, वी वांट टू गो टू द कैंटीन एंड हैव अ चा, चाय बटाटवड़ा, समोसा, बर्गर, वट एवर. वी डू नॉट आस्क अवर बॉडी वेदर अवर बॉडी रियली लाइक्स इट और इट इज यू नो वेदर इट इज रियली रिक्वायर्ड. As the meeting is going on, suddenly I think if principal decides there is a very good session and everybody gets a free Swiggy voucher, which has to be taken within next 1 hour, they have to redeem it of 200 rupee voucher. Everybody will, you know, buy some of the other dish and they will order and they will consume the dish without even asking. So this is not supposed to be done. Just because we are getting the food in front of us, we are not supposed to eat it unless we are really, really hungry. Okay. So what is the best time to eat? What is the best, how we can go about the food? Okay, simple. Just follow the three course meal concept. Breakfast, lunch, and the dinner. Okay, breakfast early in the morning. The lunch is to be taken between 12 noon to latest by 2:30 p.m. Not more than that. So restrict your time of lunch between 12 to 2:30 and the dinner time is the classics, you know, the Ayurveda advices to be taken at sunset. Is it possible today? No, definitely not. Will it be possible in coming future? No, because everybody will be working and by the time they will work, they will reach home. It will be easily 6:30 or 7 o'clock or maybe later on. So what is to be done? Try to keep the dinner as close to the sunset as possible. Okay, this is possible. People are doing it and the results, they are really fantastic. Because when we come home, the what we do is we take, you know, tea, we'll have some samosa, batarvada, we'll have some, you know, farsan, chivda, whatever. We'll have some biscuits. And then at 10:30, we'll have a dinner. By that time, our food should be already in the digestive phase because current research today shows that, you know, our metabolism or digestive capacity, it slowly goes down after the sunset. So it is not possible for us to eat at the sunset, but how close to the sunset can we eat? 7:30 p.m., 8:30 p.m. or maximum by 8 to 8:30 p.m. is the best time to have your dinner. And on the same note, the next day breakfast should be taken at 8 or 8:30 because you're not supposed to fast more than 12 hours also. That is also not good because your body also requires the nourishment. Not supposed to fast your body. Okay, so this is the best time. If you eat at 8 or 8:30 in the at night, again you are supposed to take the breakfast or maybe before 8 or 8:30. That is the reason. Trust me, you will feel what the difference does it make. It takes, it creates a wonderful results. People with high cholesterol who are continuously taking some allopathic medicine to you know, lower their cholesterol have been following this. They have been doing Surya Namaskar. They have shifted the time of their dinner. Okay, so and they have got the wonderful results. So what some questions might be, sometime if there is a function, you know, I'm little bit late and I have to eat little bit late, the dinner is little late, maybe at 9:30 or 10 o'clock, what should you do? So if you eat at that time, your breakfast time should be little bit you know adjusted. So just because it is 8 o'clock in the morning and you have to go to work, you will take a sandwich, put a jam, put cheese in, and put it in your mouth and go to work. It doesn't happen so. You are not supposed to do it. Because you have had the dinner late, just change your time of breakfast as and when you feel hungry. These small tricks, because it takes, you know, 6 to 8 hours for us to, for the whole food to get digested and push it into the large intestine. If we start eating again and again, according to Ayurveda, the food doesn't get digested properly and it forms into something called as ama or the toxic. And according to Ayurveda, all this toxic material is the whole and the root cause of any disorder. Supposingly, this toxic, if it goes in your bloodstream, it takes a form of cholesterol. If it is settling on your liver, settling on the liver, it is termed as fatty liver. If it goes and settles under your eye, it is called as xanthoma. And this is how about the Ayurveda moves forward in treating any disorder. So first, if you go to any Ayurvedic physician, he will advise you the proper diet. And this itself takes care about 50% of your problems. So the health is in whose hand? The health is in our hand only. Okay. So no doubt, everybody, as I told you, everybody likes to eat, you know, try different things. paneer, Chinese pasta, Italian food. So have this in the quantity, but also see to it that when you're having these foods, which are basically really, really heavy to digest, the best thing about it is you have to do fasting also. Okay. So whenever you must have seen our mothers or relatives, anybody, they keep a fast. They used to keep a fast at least once a month, a particular day they used to keep for fasting. On that day, ideally, you are supposed to have very light diet. Okay. Maybe a small fruit or maybe some, soup or something like that. But you're not supposed to have heavy diet. People now, they are doing ulta these days. They are having, all the milkshakes, and they're having sabudana, which is really, heavy food items, which are not supposed to do. Now you will say, what does fasting, have got to do with all these things? That is spiritual and that is towards God. I'm an atheist and I don't believe in all these things. But it is scientifically proven. One person who worked on this concept of fasting, his theory is called as the theory of autophagia, and he won the Nobel Prize on this because he said the theory of autophagia, that is one person, if it fast, it is helpful in eating the probable cancer cell which are produced by the body. When we fast, the body itself starts digesting this, would-be cancerous cell. And on this concept, he gets a Nobel Prize. And so he is not an Indian, okay? Whereas the fasting concept was originally found in India and, put into minds of the people because people were God-fearing. So they used to keep at least one day, either Monday, Thursday, Friday, whichever God you like, according to that you choose. Okay, why? Because a body, is a biological clock. You have to fix a day. So body automatically starts realizing that, okay, today is a day. My body is going, I'm not going to get food. So I have to adjust myself. So whatever we have digested, excess food that we have consumed, slowly starts getting digested. Our stomach gets a rest. And again, we are ready to start with a new day all over. So these simple things, what I have mentioned are, choti choti par moti baate. Okay. It's a long thing, but I think our time is also up. So in this limited time, whatever I've told, I will come to the last part. Again, now doctor has told everybody everything regarding the diet and everything, and he has not told the medicine, right? There are two things in the world. Till a doctor suggests any medicine, he is not a doctor. And till an engineer, he repairs any household electronic item, maybe a radio or a fridge or anything, he is not termed as engineer, at least in the house, though he has got a B.Tech, M.Tech degree, whatever. So it is like that. So I will do that part. So you all should not say doctor has not given any medicine for us. Because in Goa or in anything, any state that we go, the longer the prescription of the doctor, the best doctor he is. The longer the test he writes for us, the better doctor he is, according to us. But according to a scholar, he says the best doctor is the person who gives the least medicine. So I follow that trend. So we have to more focused upon our diet and our lifestyle. So there is no need of any medicine. But still, this has been given by the scientific, experimentation research. It is something called as the Ayush Kada. This is good for this pandemic. Okay. So what does this consist of? I will just message this to, Archana after this message, and it will be passed upon to everybody of you. But still, I will mention the ingredients. The ingredients are tulsi, then the dalchini or cinnamon, then pepper, then dry ginger, sunth, which is called as the dry ginger powder, and the black raisins, manuka. All these things, like tulsi leaves, you can take 4 to 5 leaves, small 1 inch to 2 inch piece of a dalchini, 1 to 2 peppers, not more than that. Sorry. A half teaspoon of, dry ginger powder, and 3 to 4, the manuka or the black raisins. You have to boil it. If you are taking 1 cup of water, you have to reduce it to half by adding all these ingredients, make half cup, and you have to drink it warm. Okay. Maximum twice a day, not more than that. The quantity, what I have here mentioned, you have to stick to it. If you are taking more kada, it doesn't imply that you are going to get more immunity. Okay. But if you take more, there may be problems like a little bit of hyperacidity. So kada maximum once or maximum twice a day, you can take per day. Okay, and the second one is a little bit of, we can talk about the social etiquettes. Now, only thing I will ask everybody is, you don't have to forget the SMS. Okay, everybody likes to SMS. Okay, so SMS is what? S for social distancing, M, that is for mask, wearing a mask, and third one is the use of hand sanitizers when we are outside. If we are close to a, you know, a tap or a basin, it is best thing to wash our hands. Some advices I will give you is, continuous use of hand sanitizer again and again is also not advised, and it is also not good. Okay, because it, after all, it is made up of alcohol and it will cause dryness to your hands, etc. So excess use of the alcohol based sanitizer, it also not advised. The mask which we are using, see to it that the mask is on the nose and not below it. Many people are wearing mask from here. Okay, it doesn't give, doesn't solve the purpose. In the mask you are using, if it is a cloth mask, see to it that the mask what you are using, it is not used in more than 20 times. If it is a cloth mask, okay, you have to discard it and you have to use a new one after every 20 uses of the mask. And when we are wearing a mask, see to it that again and again we are not touching the front part again, because it will not solve any purpose. It is better not to wear a mask, or if you are using mask in a wrong way or the improper way. So you have to mask which is totally covering your nose and your mouth, and you should not touch the front part again and again, pull it down, wear it again, you know. So all these things are again very, very important. Social distancing is another thing. You know, whenever we read about everything in the newspaper, today 400 cases are there, 500 are there, 700 are there, we get scared. But the moment when we are out, we are going to the market or everything, we forget the concept of the social distancing. A very simple thing, just by maintaining 1 meter distance from another person can give us protection from this disease, is really the best thing what we can do. So try to avoid going to the crowded places. And again, as I told you, it is the best thing about it is the 80% recovery rate is there. And yes, Ayurvedic medicines and homeopathic medicines are also again now playing a key role in, as well as the treating the mild as well as the moderate symptoms. It has been already started. So yes, Ayurveda, homeopathy, together with the allopathic science, it can help us in fighting this pandemic. To stay healthy, those who are healthy, to keep them healthy, and those who are infected, to see to it that the worsening of the disease is prevented. By all these things, if we maintain, I think we can live happily. Don't get panic. Okay, there's a very one trending line which is going on in Goa is Bhiupachi Garaj Na. This nothing to do with politics, but yes, don't lose hope is the moral of the story. So if you all have watched the movie Three Idiots, there Amir Khan says, no, all is well. So dil ko tasalli to milti hai. Okay, and everybody is to, in that colony, he says ki aram se so jate the. The blind security is to say all is well. So we don't have to be blind here. We have to see, and also we have to tell our heart that all is well. Everything will be fine. This positive approach will only help us to move ahead. Okay. So that's why be positive, don't get scared, follow all these things, and definitely, even if you are infected, trust me, because every day I work in a primary health center, every day we see about 20-30 patients or more. Many of them are having cold fever like conditions. Not everybody among them is corona positive. So even if you are COVID corona positive, don't get scared. Follow whatever things I have told you. And in a few days of time, you will see that you will definitely help in the coming out of it. And if you take care of yourself, we will not be definitely in the victim of this corona. So with these things, I think I'm taking a halt because the time is up. If any questions are there, one or two questions, you all can put in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Only thing is, kindly do not put personal questions. I'm having COVID, I'm having trouble, I'm having this trouble. I won't be able to answer it, really sorry. But rather than this, if anything is there, I think you all can ask me. Okay. So thank you. I hope it was a very good and not a boring session for everybody.
Yes, doctor. It was very nice session. And looking at this, we understand how lifestyle is only important. to maintain anything like immunity or to boost immunity and to also stay positive, it is the only lifestyle that is important. So let me talk about stress in brief for now. So I will be presenting my screen here. So my second part is like stress during the times of COVID. So first of all, we all have to understand that stress, it is common to all. It is not like I'm not going to have stress and someone is the one who is presenting very well is not going to be stressed. Even me who is presenting here, though I give lots of webinars and many sessions I have, even me at being at this place, even I am stressed. Like before conducting this webinar, I was stressed. Okay, because my heart was pounding very fast and all these things were happening. So stress is common to all. Okay, so we have to know the facts about stress. So here, as you all can see, a bell-shaped graph is there, wherein when the stress is increasing and is at this level, that is very low level. Okay, so stress is going from this line and it is at very low level, and this is the performance. So when the stress is at very low level, that time our performance will be very low. As you all can see, the line is down, okay, because we are at the calmer side of it. Okay, so our performance will not be that high. Like if we are not even stressed about this COVID situation, and that time we will not perform, or we will not use mask, we will not use sanitizer, because we are not stressed at all. So it is very much important that stress is at this phase, that is also known as eustress. Okay, so when we are at this level of stress, that time our performance can be seen on top level. So we will take good care of ourselves. So we should have some level of stress in our life so that we can perform in a better way. Okay, but when the stress level increases, goes on increases, that time again the performance level is going to go down. Okay, and that phase is known as de-stress, because we cannot perform anything. Like in this COVID situation, if we are de-stressed, that time what is going to happen is we are going to just sit at home itself, in the room, sitting inside the room and not going anywhere outside. So we are not performing at all. So it is obviously affecting us. So like if you all are very stressed about it, that time you all are not going to come out to answer the exams, right? So that is known as de-stress. So we have to be in this phase wherein we are performing our activities in a proper way. Okay, so we should make stress our friends. Yes, this is we never hear it from someone else, like we should make stress our friend, stress is bad for our health. We hear all such kind of things, but we never listen to this statement wherein we are saying to make stress our friend. Now why that is I'm going to explain you all. Now when I will be under eustress, that is required amount of stress, and suppose I'm taking one example, like if I'm going on a trek, okay, so I'm like exhausted completely, I cannot walk anymore, okay, so suddenly I see a snake, that time what is going to happen is my heart is going to like beat very fast, right? Because I'm stressed now. Now what is this happening? Because of this fast heartbeats, the oxygen rate that is going in every part of our body is very high. Okay, so even our brain is going to get lots of oxygen when our heart will beat fast. So obviously the decision that we are making will be good. So because of this heart pounding, I will run fast. Even though I was drained completely, because if my heart is like beating very fast, I'm getting more oxygen to all parts of my body, and it is just preparing my body to like act properly in that particular situation, just like in COVID situation. Because we are stressed here and our heart will beat fast when we'll be coming out of the house, and that will give oxygen to all parts of our body, which will improve our behavior towards it. Okay, now Now, why we have to make or look at the stress in a positive way? Like it was, this research was done in Harvard University in the Department of Psychology. Okay. So when we look at stress in a positive way, that time our, this is our blood vessel. Okay. So that time the blood vessel remains in normal state. So what happens is the blood flow through this blood vessel is good and it is not going to affect our heart. But when we will look at the stress in a negative way, we will think that it is a negative response. That time our blood vessel is going to get thicker. So when it gets thick, the blood flow will not be normal in this state. Okay, so our heart is going to be affected with that. So it is very much important that the way we look at our stress should be good. We should look at our stress in a positive way. I think someone's mic is unmuted. Kindly mute. Okay, so now life hacks for stress. I'm not going to go in deep with all these things because doctor has already told you all like how it is important to make right. So we should have a proper time, like we get up early in the morning and we do all the later stuff which are important. So we should manage our time so that our day is not wasted completely. When our day is wasted, at the end of the day, we are going to be stressed about it, feeling guilty, right? So we have to manage our time. Then sleep, as doctor have already told the importance of sleep, because we have to give rest to our brain, right? When we give rest to our brain, that time it is like going to stay away from all the negative things, okay, like stress and all such kind of things like depression, stress, everything. So sleep is very important because we are giving rest to our brain. Then water. Now water, as doctor has already told us, like in Goan situation, it is like good not to have too much of water. Whenever we feel thirsty, we should drink water. Because brain is also made up of water, and when we drink water, it is like it gives energy to our brain also, because brain is one part that is constantly being working even at night. Okay, so good breakfast, as doctor has already told about breakfast, like if you all are having late dinner, then avoid like eating fast in the morning. But good breakfast is better because it is like we are fasting for the whole night. So when we are waking up, we are breaking that fast, right? And it is very much required for our brain, because as I have told you, that brain is constantly working even when we are sleeping. Yoga, yes, it is good for both physical as well as mental health. Like doctor has told the importance of Surya Namaskar. Leisure time. We feel leisure time is a waste of time. No, it is not waste of time. We have to do at least for 5 minutes what we like for in a day. Okay, we can combine it with some other activities, like if someone likes singing, if I'm having very busy schedule, okay, but it is like I'm busy the whole day, but I like singing. So what can I do is, while having bath, I can play music and I can sing around, right? So it is like my mental state will be in a positive state. Okay, so it is very much important that we keep our mental health in a good place. So leisure time is very much important. And so positive social support, we have to keep that in mind, that all the times we are not going to feel like positive, all the times we cannot be happy. Okay, so sometimes we will get sad, sometimes we will be in fear of COVID or anything, of exam. So we have to share it with someone. We have to share each and every emotion with someone. So it is very much important to have that friend or have that any human being, okay, with us, with whom we can share about our feelings. Okay. And this is not just for mental health. It will help us like to keep our stress away from us, and it is going to boost our immunity at the same time. So it is just our lifestyle that is important, as I am like focusing and stressing on it. It is just our lifestyle that is important, and the way we sleep late at night, we are more on phones in these days, right? So it really affects us. We are not like we don't understand it, but it really affects us. Okay, yeah, the way I said, it boosts. So don't focus on negative, that is virus outside, because you all can focus on positive inside, that is your immunity inside. So if you all are going to have this good lifestyle, then you all are obviously going to, like, I'm not saying you all are completely like not going to get infected with the virus, but when you all are focusing on your immunity, that is like positive thing that you all are focusing on, okay? And obviously when you all will be coming to college to answer this exam, obviously you all are going to look at your friends after so many months, right? Like 6 months have passed and you all have not even met your friends or not even looked at your friends, even your teachers. Trust me, at that time your endorphins are going to get released, and that is one of the happy hormone, okay? So when it will be released, obviously you will feel good about it, okay? And yes, but with that excitement, just don't go and hug your friend or do something that is going to, like, bad for you all at this phase at least, okay? So try to maintain distance, try to, like, focus on your immunity, and everything will be good, okay? You all don't have to, like, focus on this only, that is negative, that virus. You all can focus on yourself also. Now, this was it from my side when it comes to stress. Now, I think you all can ask questions if you all have, okay? Anything if you all want to ask, you all can ask, like, especially if you all want to ask anything to doctor, you all can ask it now, because it will help you all. So if you all have any queries, please ask. You all can type it in the chat box. Yes, students, please ask.
You know, I thought lawyers love to argue a lot, but no arguments here. I'm a little bit surprised.
Anyone, if you all have any doubt regarding, like, how to boost immunity and all such things, you all can please ask.
So no doubt, either there can be two possibilities. All I have understood everything, or all I have understood nothing. Yes. So I'm really confused whether all have understood everything or they have not understood whatever I've told. So, okay.
I think they have understood everything, doctor. Doctor, I had one question. Like, many of them, they are like going into they take steam a lot. So is it like advised?
Okay, good question. This is basically okay. So yeah, now questions have started to come. Okay, see, taking steam, I will remove any misconception that are present in our mind. Taking the steam will not kill the virus, okay? Because it takes a very high temperatures to kill the virus, and just taking the steam, which is when it goes to our node, it will be hardly around 40 degrees to 40, 42 or 45 degree max. Which is not going to kill. So why do we take steam? Steam is just taken so that our sinus, you know, from our nose and the sinus which are there, they are working properly. They are not sinus, they are not draining. Just to keep our sinuses clean, any mucus accumulation there, if it is there, it will just melt and it will come out. So that is why we take steam. Okay. As I told you, because when we say sinusitis, according to Ayurveda, it is a cough which is present in the sinus. It gets accumulated and then it causes infection. So when we take steam, this, because of the heat, this cuff gets melted and it comes out, it flows out, and chances of it getting infected are very, very less. Okay, that's why the steam is advised. But as I told you, anything which is done excess or more in time is definitely not good, because now it is raining. It is September month, which is going to end soon, and October will start. And everybody knows in October, there's a little bit of heat in the body, October heat, which is called. So in the heat, if you are taking a lot of steam, it is definitely not good for us. because there might be a little bit of, you know, small boils that might come on our face because of the heat. And taking steam in excess is also not good for our eyes. Again, why? Because today now everybody is, you know, watching a lot of mobile. Again, we are exposing ourselves to the light. And again, if you are taking steam on top of that, a lot of time it is not good. So per day, once steam, if you are taking, that is also fine. If you are coming from outside, then you are at home, taking steam for maximum 2 to 3 minutes max, it is sufficient. Okay. Mm. In excess also, it is not good.
Okay.
One question here is, can we eat fruits in the morning? Okay. The best time to eat fruits is either morning or evening, but fruit should be taken like in the, when your stomach is a little bit on the emptier side. Okay. Yeah. So if you're for the breakfast, if you want to have fruits, it is okay. Best fruits you all can, as I told you, the best fruits are which are seasonally available. Okay. So whatever is available in this season, those fruits you all can have. But if you have the history, you know, of frequent cough and cold, I mean, I will not advise bananas. Okay. We can't eat citric. Yeah, because citric fruit, as I told you, they are a little bit is sour in taste. All citric fruits are sour in taste, right? So anything that is sour will increase his cough and the chances of getting cough and cold become high. So if you want to have, you know, you can have apple, you can have papaya, all these fruits. You can have pear also. Okay. Guava you can have, pear you can have, all fruits you can have. Banana to very less extent. And if you are having like a fruit plate, if you want to eat, cut these fruits in small sizes, put little bit of honey on top of that, sprinkle little bit of pepper and elaichi powder, okay, cardamom powder, elaichi, and then you can have fruit. So this will not trouble you, but avoid eating fruits after your lunch or dinner, which is strictly contraindicated. So in the morning, yes, if you're hungry, you can have fruits in the morning or in the evening time before sunset.
Okay. Is there
any substitute for hand sanitizer in Ayurveda? Because yes, but what happens is according to the WHO guidelines, World Health Organization guidelines, any sanitizer has to be based in alcohol only. There has to be at least 70% alcohol based. So we cannot use any, we are not permitted to use any sanitizers. Okay. So currently, if you are using any sanitizer, you use it, but with caution. Whenever it is possible, best is to wash your hands with soap. And when you are out in public, you all can use sanitizers. We had heavy dinner, then according to you, sir, how much hours fasting is necessary? If you have heavy dinner early in the morning, whenever your body is demanding little bit of food, you can have breakfast. But as I told you, fasting more than 12 hours is also not advised. So if you have had dinner at late night, maybe 10:30, the next breakfast you all can have at 10:30 max. So once we come from the market and all, what we should do, it is compulsory to have bath and all. No, if you come from the market, it is not required to have bath. Best thing to do is change your clothes, you know, wash clothes, and you can just no need to take a shower and all. Parts which are your hands and feet, if you wash them in your face, it is sufficient. Because frequent bath also not advised. You might all catch a cold with that. After we eat, why should we don't have to drink water? This is a good question, because as you know, our stomach is filled with food, and water is to digest the food. Our body requires a lot of energy. Energy means what? The heat principle should required is. And what, as we know, water is against the fire principle of the body. You're not supposed to advise, not supposed to consume a lot of water immediately after having food. So after having food, you can take, you know, half cup of water after, you know, 45 minutes. The best time to drink water is when you're having food. By sip, if you take one or two cups of water, that is fine. But after food, don't do that.
Okay, so
Okay.
There are three more questions.
Okay.
So
yes.
I think, yes.
Okay, we'll take these three questions and then we'll take, yeah. Some workout in gym and consume chicken or any meat on daily basis harmful for health. See, the thing about the, you know, meat products, Ayurveda says, Ayurveda, first of all, Ayurveda is not against, you know, Ayurveda doesn't support vegan diet or only vegetarian or ghaspus, what you'll call, only vegetable diet. It is not advised, trust me. It also, Ayurveda also talks about meat. It also talks about egg and all the other dairy products as well as the meat products. But the thing remains here is the animals which are used, I mean, used for slaughtering, the meat what we consume should be fresh. Okay, do we get the fresh chicken or not? That is also one thing. And today with the chicken which are we get in the market, and many a times it is seen that they are pre-given medication, they are shot with antibiotics or they are shot with some steroids so that they gain weight. So all these things, they are harmful for us. So if we are taking the chicken or meat products, we have to see that they are fresh. Again, also with the fish, same thing. If we are getting fish from a very local farm, it is good for us. But as you all know, the fish is found in the deep sea and then they are freezed and they are, you know, the person is consuming it. So that's why we have to restrict the consumption. So meat you all can take as long as it is fresh. Okay. And best thing to have fish or chicken is how we use it with our traditional spices. Then the harmful effects are not observed. Okay. All the spices, they basically help in good digestion and assimilation of the meat products. Okay. So if you are having this meat products, it is best time to consume is the lunch and not for dinner. Because as I told you, the metabolic rate will go down. So best time to consume it is, it will be in the lunch time. While drinking water, why it is said we should sit and drink. Okay. There are certain norms which are put. Okay. The scientific explanation to this is yet to be derived, because as if I tell this to a modern doctor, he will start laughing to it. But I'm having the data with me. I have more than 35 patients who are complaining of, you know, heel pain. Their heel used to pain and they have gone to all the specialists, you know, orthopedic and everything. They have tried different medicines. But only thing I changed, I advised them to do is to stop drinking water while in a standing position, because the common point what I found, and all these things, I mean, all the patients, majority 80-90 of them were, you know, female patients, ladies. So before, when they used to do the household work, they used to stand and drink water, and they used to get severe pain in their heel or in their knees. So when you sit and drink, it really helps. I have the necessary statistics, but according to modern science, how this thing works, we are yet to find out the reason for this. Okay, sir, what have you to say about oil pulling advantages or disadvantages? I think, okay, this will be the final question. Okay, but okay, good thing that you have talked about the oil pulling thing. Okay, oil pulling is the modern term. What Ayurveda says, it is called as the Kavala. So you all can take the sesame oil or the coconut oil, and you know, take two to three tablespoon of oil in your mouth, and you know, just start moving the oil in your oral cavity till your mouth gets filled with the saliva. Then you have to spit out. This is basically very good for your oral hygiene. Okay, because of this, your the gums get proper good nutrition. They are not getting, you know, any infection or any bleeding. It takes care of any bleeding. It gives strength to your teeth also. The things like sensitivity to your teeth, all these things are reduced. But also according to Ayurveda, oil pulling also gives you advantages. Is your voice is, you know, while talking, it gives you a better quality of voice. Your voice, I mean, you don't get tired even after talking for long, which is, you know, good for all the law students here. So they should do definitely start practicing this oil pulling. Okay, and it also helps in better working of all the five sense organs in the body, because the main controlling thing of all the five sense organs is in the brain, and it is said that the oil pulling also helps in for the better working of all the five sense organs of our body.
Okay, so I think
okay. Can we? Okay.
I think
we, can we take these two questions or we have to stop? Time is up.
Yes, yes.
Hello.
The last question. Yes, yes, doctor.
Okay, fine. Yeah. Okay, fine. Yes. I have read once that the breakfast has to be had within 1 hour of waking up, but you should, you know, feel hungry. Yes. See, according to Ayurveda, what is they have said is, as I told you, the indigestion is the root cause of almost all the disorders that we are facing today. So Ayurveda strongly advises that once a previously taken food is digested, then only we have to take the next meal. So in the morning time, in the daytime, when the sun is up, it is okay if we take the repeated meals. But once the night is one night starts and the next day is up, if the previously consumed food is not digested, we are not supposed to take, you know, the new meal. So this what you are telling is not good, because what you have taken for dinner itself is not digested. Why? Because your digestion capacity is low, and on top of that, if you are loading your body again with food, your digestive, I mean the fire element of your body, has to do a lot of work, and again it will lead to indigestion and everything. That's why, as I told you, this is not a clock or this is not a machine. 8 o'clock you have to have breakfast. No, it is according to your hunger, it is according to the season which is there. Because in winter season you might be more hungry, in the summer season your appetite might go on a little bit lower side. So run according to your body's demand. Okay, as I told you, but again, just because you're not hungry, that doesn't mean you have to fast more than 12 hours. If it is more than 12 hours, you can take something light food, such as some soup or something like that. You can start with that. Okay.
Is it advisable to eat an apple itself?
Yes, there's the saying is there, an apple a day keeps the doctor away, and it is, unfortunately, it is not true. So, but yes, you can have any fruit basically in that matter. So apple you can have in the evening time, but not after, you know, after having a heavy lunch or a heavy dinner. The food advising, taking any fruit is not advised. So you can have an apple, no issue, as per your hunger.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rai, on behalf of GR Kare College of Law. Extend my gratitude to Dr. Aditya Barve for giving us such a valuable time and sharing such important message that how we can boost our immunity, and also by sharing one recipe which doctor has mentioned that he will be sharing with, and then I will be sharing with you all. And yes, it is. From all these things, we come to know that it is our lifestyle that is important, how we have to sleep on time, and how the sleep and everything is important for us. Thanks very much, doctor.
So yes, thanks a lot for giving me this opportunity. So I'm thankful to the college, all the management staff, the principal, and also to Archana for inviting me for this session. So thank you. Thanks a lot.
Yes. Thank you very much. All the students, I will be sharing a feedback form with you all. So later on, you all can fill the form. And if you all have, if you all want to meet for any stress management or something like that, if you all feel that you all are getting distressed with this, you all can tell me that you all want to talk to me about it. Okay. So later on, I will be sharing the link. Please fill in the feedback form. Okay. Thank you very much for participating. Okay, bye everyone. Thank you. Thanks for you all too for joining the webinar.